Welcome back to Future Perfect. One of the biggest movements right now in digital photography is going underwater. Hindi po underwater as in bankrupt, ha? Underwater, literally. Well, getting into it is easy enough. Just purchase a ruggedized digicam that already comes waterproof out of the box. But now, how much better would it be if you could bring a full-blown DSLR on your dive? The next challenge, though, is finding the right housing for your specific camera. And that's where we turn to splash underwater imaging. And let's dive right into it with Jovic Santos from Marketing and Sales Division of Splash Underwater Imaging. Jovic, thanks for coming to the show.
Thanks for inviting
me. We wanted to put in a tank here and a diving platform.
You in the water?
Not exactly. I'll be outside and you'll be there. Unfortunately, Cirque du Soleil borrowed the tank. So now, underwater photography has been around, obviously, for some time.
Film before.
And using film. Now, digital photography. Just how much different would it be using the kind of casings that we have now?
Well, the enclosures, the housings, are basically just the same from the previous designs.
Okay.
It's just that the cameras now have changed from film to digital, thereby making it easier for the photographer to see the photo after the shoot. If it's nice or not, then shoot it again while underwater. Well, film, you had 24, 36 shots. Digital, 16 gigabyte cards, whatever you want to have inside the camera.
So you don't even have to swap CF cards, right?
No, not at all.
Yeah. How many people now actually get into this underwater photography? I mean, in the first place, is it difficult to learn?
With digital cameras now, it's far more easier to shoot.
Yeah.
Because like I said, when you shoot in the water, you think that you need to adjust the light or adjust the aperture speed. It's an actual, you know, result that you can see while underwater.
Yeah.
With film, it was a little bit, the learning curve was so slow. With digital now, it just goes up.
Okay.
And anybody can get into it. You can start from, you know, small iPhone 4S housing,
uh-huh,
or a Canon S100, uh-huh, or DSLR setup.
So you don't have to practice with it first on dry land. I mean, need to practice with it when you're underwater, right?
It helps to know the camera, because the mastery of the housing is the mastery of the camera. If you don't know the camera, you don't know how
because
to use the housing.
On the outside, of course, in the housing, actually would be all the controls that are on the camera itself.
Yes.
Right.
As
close as possible. So you just sort of put on the casing what would correspond to the camera's own controls on the body. So let's begin with the smallest one. And you say that's an iPhone casing.
Yeah, this is an iPhone 4S casing. It's made of aluminum and it houses that mobile phone.
Okay.
Which you can use for a dive. So you can see here the controls,
mm-hmm,
that will say if you want to shoot it with video or stills.
Mm-hmm.
And
I'm curious though, Jovic, did you bring an iPhone?
Yes, I do.
All right. So let's see you slip that into your iPhone casing.
I have to open the case.
All right. So let's see how, you know, I actually am curious how easy it is to put the phone itself into the casing. So there are clips.
Yeah, this is a 60-meter housing, actually. It's a 180-foot housing, so it's a diving case, but can also be used for land, beach-going and stuff like that.
May I hold it? I see. So aluminum.
It's aluminum,
but still quite heavy. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Of course, when you're underwater, it doesn't matter, right?
Yep.
Right.
So just in there. Snaps right there.
Okay. So it's waterproof. The seals, whatever, they're actually,
there's an O-ring.
That
provides
there are gaskets,
a sealing.
So let's see.
When you press,
mm-hmm,
this one, you have a slider and you have the camera button there.
Uh-huh.
When you press this and it goes to camera mode,
uh-huh,
then there you are.
Okay.
And if you want to go video,
mm-hmm,
you press this again and
it
shifts to video.
All right.
Then if you want to take videos, you just press the record button.
Okay.
So I am recording you right now.
Okay. We're underwater, so
you know.
I'm just going to simulate it. Oh, come on, Joby. Good.
All right. Yep, there you go. Tony Velasquez underwater.
I'm swimming.
In an iPhone 4 video.
I'm like Dora. Was it Dory? Dory. Next Dory. Swimming. Let's go swimming. Okay. Fantastic. Okay. And then?
You cannot text.
You cannot text. Okay.
So I always get that question.
That's a good lesson for the MMDA. The only way you can get drivers not to text is to let them drive through water. So it works basically all the controls.
For camera and video.
Yeah. And okay, of course you know the lens.
Yep.
Well, for the housing itself should mm-hmm. be pretty clear. I mean, how do you make sure that you know it doesn't fog up or you know it doesn't clog up or anything?
For aluminum housing, it's a little bit different because it's resilient to temperature. So even if the temperature changes, it doesn't
hindi
affect.
Mist, hindi nagmo-moist. Hindi,
wala. Okay. For polycarbonate or plastic, you do need silica gel.
Yeah, just to make sure na hindi mag-up yung moisture.
For aluminum, it's not an issue.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then also the lenses. Yeah. These are measured specifically to make sure that the glass
distortion.
Yes, they're equidistant to the lens, yes. The aperture, so it does not make any issues with regards to having if it's sharp or not.
Okay. How much would that cost?
This one is 15,000.
15,000.
Yeah, for a housing like this, for an iPhone 4.
So pati sa Kim store meron ganun.
I hope Kim is going to carry it.
Okay. So let's go to the next case thing. All right, this one corresponds to what? A standard DSLR.
No, that's a Canon S100.
A specific shot for a Canon S100.
Yep, it's it also works similarly to this one, but this is a clamp shell type.
Okay.
So you press it in, you pull it open, you drop in the camera.
Right.
Then you have the controls, corresponding controls in the
Canon. To the Canon. Okay.
Yeah, for the Canon S100. Then you can zoom. This is full control.
Full control.
So it's like having the camera on land. Mm-hmm. It's just that it's enclosed underwater.
Mm-hmm.
Goes down to 180 feet.
180 feet.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. And this one?
This one is an aluminum housing. This is for a Nikon DSLR.
Okay.
This is more for the professional users.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a little bit more serious. It's for the bigger DSLR cameras. It's a C-cam housing. It's actually the Rolls Royce of the housings.
Really?
So normally people who use this one are normally making money off of that.
Did you say, what is it? It's designed for the Nikon.
It's designed for a Nikon, specific Nikon D300.
Okay, but I'm reading the back, Jovic, right now. It says a C-cam designed for Canon EOS.
It can be an EOS. It can
so
be a
compatible.
Nikon.
Compatible.
Yeah, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, normally, how big should the Nikon be? Because this looks huge compared to the camera itself.
Yeah, for the DSLR, it's a little bit different because the controls are a little bit more. Let me just open it.
All right.
The controls are a little bit more detailed. So as you can see, you know they need more space to have shafts and gear trains and stuff like that to control the camera. So without that space, you won't be able to control the camera. So the housing is slightly bigger than the camera.
Than the camera itself.
Yeah.
Okay.
But the housing is also three times more expensive than the cam.
I can imagine. All right. And that can go how deep?
This one is an 80 meter housing. So that goes down to 240 feet. Okay. So it's serious depths. But we don't normally go to that depth. Even for myself, I've been shooting for quite a while now.
Because the light is not too,
there's
not available light.
I think you shoot, right?
No, I actually wade through floods most of the time. So. That doesn't count. All right, so, and the monster of them all. What is this?
Well, this one is not complete yet. Actually, there's no port for the lens. The housing is to the camera body. And then the port, this one in the front, which you can actually remove, is for the lens. So depending on what lens.
So you call it a port. So
yes.
It's very nautical when you're underwater.
Exactly. So if you have a different lens for a specific camera that you use, you have to change the port as well.
So you're underwater and you have all that gear.
Yes. You cannot open it underwater. You have to choose whether you're shooting wide or macro or what have you.
Okay.
And then this one also comes with a very specialized speed viewfinder in the back. This is all from Enon, allows you to see it better. You can have a look at the viewfinder there.
Okay. What? You're naked. Okay, that's just my imagination.
If that was the case, we'd sell a lot.
Oh yeah, I can imagine. So yeah, basically, yeah. I'll just take a look at that. Yeah.
It increases the magnification.
It sort of like brings the subject a little closer
and clearer
to your point of view.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, clearer is a relative term because I think my eyesight's going, but yeah, he did look bigger. You no longer look like the small cameraman. compared to the small lady.
Okay. So pretty much, if you go underwater for shooting, if you're, you know, snorkeling 20, 30 feet or diving 20, 30 feet, you normally don't need an external light. You can use the sun.
Yeah.
There's always this stigma that if you go into underwater photography, it's very expensive. It's expensive if you invest in a lot, but you don't have to spend all the way.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean, this is all the way.
This is all the way. Yeah. This is pretty serious.
Yeah.
But you can start with something like this or something for the Canon, which...
I'm kind of curious though, Jovic, because a lot of point and shoot cameras are out there, you know, whatever brand, they all look basically the same, right?
Yes, yes.
Where's the case for those?
What I normally do, I'll try to respond to you in a different manner.
Yeah.
The housings that I carry are the cameras that I test. I do not carry on stock housings for cameras, which I personally do not agree with. So anything that I sell, it's what I've tested underwater. There's a lot. There's a lot.
Okay. Which means you other camera manufacturers out there can't survive underwater. So like say, I want to bring my trusty old Android phone underwater. You don't have a casing for that, except you only want casings for the iPhone.
It's not that I don't want cases for the
Android phones.
The Android phones.
Say a Galaxy Nexus that Kim Lato is going to leave behind.
There's...
See, that's my motley laugh.
Yeah.
Whatever.
There's none for now because, you know, the housings, they're not really mass-produced.
Nah.
So it boils down to volume. Mm-hmm. So if the manufacturer cannot see them recovering the cost of the mold and stuff like that, they won't go into that.
Yeah.
But we do have an upcoming product. It's called Loxac. It's basically a plastic enclosure.
Okay.
Flexible.
Plastic?
Oh. Yes. And it's been tested by U.S. Navy.
Uh-huh.
It goes on to 180 feet as well.
Oh, that's serious.
So you can pretty much stick at your iPad if you want to bring your iPad on a dive or whatever, you what have you. I mean, probably not. But if you really need to, you can do that.
Yeah, I can think of many ways why I should bring my iPad on a dive. You know, I just want to make sure that my swimsuit illustrated edition reads well underwater too. Amazing stuff. How many customers have you had?
I really lost count.
Yeah.
I started really as a...
So there's a growing base of people who are actually into underwater photography now.
I think it's still growing.
Yeah.
It's much...
When did it grow? Well, after Ondoy? I'm trying to think of a milestone for you.
It was really the digital era.
Not the typhoons.
Not the typhoons. The digital era where they came out with, you know, cameras with video, cameras with, you know, X megapixel and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And just made
so
it
a
easier.
So a lot more ubiquitous for people, you know, to have cameras with them, whether it be on their smartphone or their tablet.
So it's really more on the digital growth on the equipment that also ushered our growth, I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
But at the same time, because when I started this one, it was a hobby. And, you know, bringing stuff from friends from when I travel, then I just decided to sell the equipment locally.
It's an expensive hobby, though,
Not necessarily. If you start with the basics, it's okay.
It's basic.
There's always this stigma that it says that it's expensive, but if you
just
come to our shop, and ask me assistance on what should be the right equipment. There's always a choice.
Yeah, just don't bring an Android phone there.
Yes, you can with the Loxac.
With the Loxac, that's coming out when?
It's available now already.
Available now.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So it's
how much would that cost?
Probably 300 pesos.
Okay, because it's just plastic.
Yeah, it's just
but
plastic.
But rated for 100 and what?
80 feet.
180
It's certified
feet?
By the U.S. Navy.
Amazing.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So you can also do that. Normally people use it for, you know, traveling, for backpacking, to avoid the elements. But then I've tested it.
Mm.
Not 280 feet.
In the spa.
Yeah, actually I did that last December.
Hey, let's go to the hot tub. Ooh, look at my pictures here. You've never tried that in a hot tub, have you, Joey?
I did last December.
I knew you would.
In a jacuzzi. Amazing.
I like the way you think. Jovic Santos from Splash Underwater Imaging. Hey, did we show some underwater images taken with these cameras? Huh?
I'm not sure if I did send, but I did send though the competition that's coming up.
Oh, okay, fantastic. We will wait for that. The competition will be?
That's on April 20 to 24.
April 20
and
to 24.
That's going to be in Cebu.
Okay.
May 4 to 8 is going
to be. So, underwater shots from the Philippines lang?
In the Philippines, yes.
In the Philippines lang, dapat ang setting, di ba?
Yes.
Not abroad.
Not abroad. Philippines lang. Yep. And okay. It's open to locals, expats, inbound. We're working together with Choose Philippines to promote the Philippines and infuse also environmental awareness.
All right. Choose Philippines, that's, you know, the program that ABS-CBN Regional Network Group, of course, is spearheading.
Yes.
Trying to promote more interest locally and abroad, you know, for all of the scenic sites that the Philippines can offer.
We're the underwater side now.
Mm.
Yeah, so that's pretty much
what they say. When you're underwater, you have more. It's more fun underwater.
It's more fun.
That's another campaign. Jovic, thanks very much for coming to the show, bringing all of the stuff from Splash Underwater Imaging.
All right, thank you very much for having us.
And thank you for joining us. I'm Tony Velasquez. You can join me again next week when we again examine the present and look ahead to the future perfect of Philippine tech.